The students here, Tom, are teenagers, really. They're people who have been significantly language deprived. That means they grew up with not a complete access to language, either ASL or English. So what they really have is what I call a dog's breakfast. It's a little bit of English, a little bit of ASL, and it's all kind of mixed up. So these kids have not been provided with that full access for many different reasons. My job now is to try to figure out how I can educate them without them having a real language base. And that's very, very challenging. And it really shows up in the reading and writing skills because many of them started here in the program with grade one, grade two, and they have been stuck in that place for many, many years. So I was trying to figure out a way to open that up, to try and get them to start using more expressive language, and to try to somehow connect that through art so they can improve their reading and writing skills. We always provide a voice. Like, for example, there's Murray over there. He will be voicing for Ada. There are voices for each of the actors. However, there's one small section that we decided not to have a voice. And the reason for that is we want the hearing people to know what it's like to be locked, not know what's going on, not being able to participate. Because we do that for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours every day. But they'll have to do it for maybe 3 seconds or 2 minutes. Yeah. So we wanted to give them a taste of what that's like for us who have to endure that for hours. It gives them more meaning, it gives them power, it gives them a feeling that their experience is growing up, the pain, the suffering that they went through was real. Because most of the time, they're taught to fake it. You know, oh yeah, I'm here. And they do the smiling and the nodding and the pretending that they know what they're doing.